What's going on, everybody? My name is Chris the Chaos Gamer, and welcome back to Pokemon Snakewood. In the last episode, we finally got through whatever this place is. Apparently, it's the boardroom, and we are still trying to find Gleece. So, before we go down there, let's go over a very, very, very quick team recap. We have Dega, our mystery egg, level 22, with Hardened, Leech Life, Tackle, and Egg Bomb. We have Maya, our Gyarados, level 26, holding the Gamble Fish, which, for those who haven't played this game, is the same thing as the Amulet Coin. Rocking in Splash, Tackle, Bite, and Surf. Yes, I want to get rid of Splash. So bad. Next is Poik, our starter, the Baltoy. Rocking in the Demon Horn, which is the same thing as the Quick Claw, with Psybeam, Hardened, Rapid Spin, and Ancient Power. And last but certainly not least, Seppuku, our Nuzleaf, level 33, holding the leftovers with Bide, Faint Attack, Cut, and Fake Out. So, I don't know what's on the other side of this door. I literally just started recording literally just after the last episode. So, let's go in. Oh no. At least we get different music this time. You got past our boardroom? Well, meddling kid, this is one room you won't get through. We'll see. We'll see about that. One thing I have noticed about these Inquisition Salaryman guys, they always use Rock-type. Which is excellent for Maya. Very good for Maya. Not good if they use Rock-type moves, but we get the Intimidate drop, which is always nice. Here's a Rock Throw. I know it does a nice bit of damage, and it's a crit. Of course it's a critical hit. Good thing this isn't a Nuzlocke. I would have lost a very, very good team member. Oh, man. Alright. Do I have a revive? Oh, yeah, I have a max revive. I don't want to use the revive quite yet. Oh, jeez. Alright. I'm gonna Bide. A move I never thought I would use this late in the game, but we'll do it. Magnitude? And of course it gets magnitude 9. But the leftovers kicks in, which is very, very, very nice, very useful. And we got one more turn. He's using Rock Throw. This is going to hurt you a lot more than it just hurts a Puku. This actually might kill, actually. If not, really close. Nope, it kills. Very nice. Graveler. Normally I would send out Maya, but Maya's kind of dead at the moment. Alright, we'll send out Poik just to see how much a Psybeam will do to this Graveler. I'm thinking it probably won't do much. Survey says... I got the confusion, which is nice. I'll take the confusion. Even better, hit yourself in confusion too. I'm not complaining. I need to heal myself. Especially Maya. Can you hit yourself in confusion again? No, there's a roll. Shouldn't really do much, nah. If you can hit yourself in confusion again while you're doing rollout, that'd be nice. Or I could kill you, that works too. Okay. These guys are getting the same level as Poik and Baltoy now. Alright, I'll tell you. The X panels on the floor unleash waves of terrible wild Pokemon. Dewey does it now. Okay. At least they're wild. These are level 5. I can run from these battles. That's a Numel? No, that's Homebound. Sounds like Numel, though. And because this level 5 is not even worth the PP to Another hobo. Terrible Pokemon, eh? Level 5? Come on, guys. I knew you can do better than that. That's Flappy. No, Fampy. I already have a ground type. I already have a ground type in Poic. Alright. More. Alright. Geodude. Let's play Trivia Time with Chris. Guess that Pokemon. This is not. Oh, I spoke over it. That was another hobo. Yeah. This is so devastating. Gee, dude. These are all level 5. I just hope it's not as long as the boardroom was, because this is really starting to... Wait. Another homebound. These guys really love their rock types. Probably a little too much. Oh my. So, as we're going through this, I want to ask you guys, how have you been? I'm actually not too bad. It is currently Saturday. Nope, Geodude again. I think we're at the end, actually, after this. Yeah, so I'm actually not all that bad. I'm actually, as of... is it the week you're watching? No. Wait. The week in which you're watching these videos are actually pre-recorded, because I'll be gone out of town. So, yeah. I'm actually doing, like, an extra week. I'm planning on doing, like, an extra week of videos. Just so that I have... So that then I don't have to record 6 more. I'd rather do 6 now than do 6 later. So...
Oh my god, excuse me.
Well, it's also early morning for me. So don't mind me yawning. Alright. Think we're getting close to the end. Because it's a spiral. Because we're going over this way, then that way. Yeah, so... I think this is the last left-hand side. I just realized all this time we haven't healed Maya. I hope there's a bag soon. Oh lord. I swear, once we get Gleece, I hope, I am praying to God. Thank you. Alright. I was gonna say, I'm hoping I don't have to walk through this again. After we save Gleece, hopefully we get teleported out. I don't want to go through this place again. I really don't. This place is long. I don't know how many levels we've been in here for, or how many episodes we've been in here for. Alright. So let's not go that way, let's go this way. Oh. What is this? Employee garden, no working, no battling, no stress. Oh. So these guys won't battle us? I want to stop you as a loyal Inquisition employee, but I can't since this is a work-free zone. I stop you, but that constitutes working, and that's not allowed in the employee garden. Interesting. Did not mean to walk in through there, because there was another way I could have went. Think you're a battler? Yes, because you're technically not in the garden. I'm on my way to the employee garden, but as a loyal salaryman, I have no option but to destroy you. Okay. Alright. We got Maya back, so... Level 30. Whatever's at the end must be... really high in levels, because these guys are magnitude 6. Doesn't affect me because I am flying type. These guys must be really high in level because these guys are already level 30. Inquisition Homebone. On the plus side, these guys use rock types, which is nice. Maya can just wipe the floor with these guys. So, I'm not entirely complaining, but it's still like... And Maya grew to level 27. Very nice. I might actually just keep Maya in the lead, just so they don't have to switch all the time at the beginning of battles. I don't know. We'll see. Maya getting all the... Relicanth, this is new. Your rock water type. Neutral damage. I figured it was neutral damage. That was a crit, though! That was a crit. I'm not complaining over crits. And, Naya with the bite flinching. Very nice. Tasty, tasty experience. Okay. So it looks like we have two ways to go. We got that way there, which looks like it was a teleporter puzzle. And we got this. No. I'll be right back. Are we there yet? We're finally back. I've cooled down a bit, or calmed down a bit. The fact that I had to walk through all of that all over again. We're gonna continue on for the next about 5 minutes. See. From the looks of it, this is a teleporter puzzle, which I don't really appreciate. What's this? Dungeons ahead, just past the storeroom. The tile flashed back. A faint noise sounds in the distance. Something dark is coming. What? The Shadaru? What is this? What is this thing? Level 80. Pulsar. Well, we know Leech Life hits it, and we're about to get hit with Future Sight that it just tried to use again for a second time. this is gonna kill. Level 80? How? More than likely, it's ghost type, so fake out isn't gonna do anything. Send out Maya. We're just gonna flat out die. Pulsar? Dead.
Where's this gonna send us?
Please tell me it sends me at the beginning, at the place with the thing. Not to the last bag. Cause if it does, I will end the episode. Where are you gonna take me? Just tell me where you're gonna take me. I'm gonna end the episode off right here. If you guys enjoyed this shit show of an episode, please hit that thumbs up button like you never clicked it before, and subscribe to the channel for more videos, hopefully not like this one. I've been Chris the Chaos Gamer, and I will hopefully see you